All right, today, very exciting. Now, on our comeback series, we're gonna do something that's actually fun to do. Instead of killing weeds or scarifying or dethatching and all that, now we're gonna do some fun stuff. So I've been cutting the yard at 1 inch, and the reason I was doing that is to have plenty of leaf coverage or enough leaf to get the weed killer on so that I could kill the weeds that we did have. So now we're gonna bring this down to like 5/8, and we're gonna hold it at 5/8 for a little while before going down to 3/4. So today we're gonna get in a mow or a blow, cause we got leaves everywhere from this state tree. I feel like calling the state and telling them they can have their tree back. I know that's not what state tree means. We're gonna get in a blow, get rid of the leaves, the mulch around the flower beds, get it all out of the grass so we don't damage our reel. Get in a trim, we'll edge this driveway here. And then we're gonna put out some goodies. We've got some liquid iron, fertilizer, seaweed extract, humic acid. All this stuff is gonna be chemicals that are gonna help us push growth, condition the soil, and give some good root development, and we'll talk about those whenever we get to that.
Yeah.
But anyway, as soon as he gets out of here, I know he's trying to make a deposit. So that's enough talking. Let's just get our blower fired up. Let's get all these leaves and mulch blown out of here so we can get this mow in. So this magnolia tree has really been a thorn in my side. I have to blow these leaves off every day if I don't want them all over the grass. And they're an evergreen, so they shed all year long. I mean, it's literally every day, 365 days a year. This thing is shedding leaves. But that's another video. I'm gonna show you how to get this grass to grow, even in the shade. So let's get this thing filled up. Yeah, I know I need a new gas jug, but I've had this for like 15 years. So it's doing pretty good. Alright, so before we get started, we need to check our reel to bed knife. And I always take a sheet of notebook paper and fold it in half. And to me, that simulates more of a grass blade. So and we don't even have to make any adjustments. So let's get this mow in. Like I said, I've been cutting it 1 inch, and 3 on here on the outlet is 1 inch. So I just turn this knob back here, and we're gonna put it between the 2 and the 3, which should give us about 5/8, cause 2 is 3/4. So I figure in between 1 inch and 3/4 is 5/8. So we're gonna go right there. We'll be right back. All right, so my camera overheated and I missed half the mow, but I wanted to at least show y'all we got some stripes going on. And there's some discoloration and most of the color is cut off, but that's what happens whenever you start lowering your height of cut. So the stuff we're about to give it is gonna bring all that back though. So let's show you what we got. So as you can see now, we're in the shade and maybe the camera won't overheat now. But this is the section or the area that's doing really poor. A lot of shade coming from this tree. It's causing this Bermuda to not really wanna grow in this area. But we're gonna mix this up in the shade. Now what we have here is our fertilizer, Pro Solutions. It's a 1500 with 6% iron. I get this from Tractor Supply. Like I said, and like I've said in many of my videos, just about everybody is close to a Tractor Supply. And if not, then you can order it online. This here is C Bio. It's a little dusty, but it's a 001. This is a seaweed extract. This is gonna be for our root growth. Okay, the fertilizer is for your top growth. This is really gonna give us that pop and really bring the grass back from this height of cut that we just lowered it down to 5/8. This right here is gonna be for root health and root development. It's gonna help this grass spread and help it fill in real nice and thick. Here, liquid iron. This is gonna give us that green up, that super green up. This is a Bonide product. It's Garden Rich liquid iron. Turns plants from yellow to green. I buy this at my local nursery. You can also order this online. I don't buy it online because I have somewhere here local that carries it, so I just go to the store and get it. And then, last but not least, humic acid. This is gonna be the binder that brings it all together. This is for soil conditioning. This is gonna help any spots in your yard that the pH might be unbalanced, or it's gonna just help all this come together and work together. And a lot of people say if you got bare spots, paint it black. Well, this stuff is black. So paint it black and it'll help it fill in. It really just makes all this stuff jive together and really work and helps wrap up this special sauce that I use. So all this stuff mixes 6 ounces per 1,000 square foot, 6 ounces per 1,000 square foot on the seaweed, the fertilizer, and also on the humic acid. Also, whenever you're mixing this many products, it's really, really important to go ahead and have your sprayer at least half full of water before you ever mix anything, because some of this may come together and like coagulate inside your jug and make like a sludge, and you don't want that. So you want this stuff mixed into water, that way it's diluted and not at its most concentrated form. So let's get it mixed up and knock this out. Alright, so we've got our special sauce put out, and as you noticed in the video, I decided not to do half of it with one jug and half of it with the other. I decided to walk at a faster pace and do north, south, east, west to get better coverage. I would like to say that you could already see the green, but there is a lot of shadows on the yard now, which in the evening that can make the grass look greener. But myself looking at it, I can already tell it's starting to green up. It's starting to pop. That liquid iron and humic acid and that fertilizer, it just really makes that grass stand on end, and it starts working pretty quick. Now here's the sad part about this is I leave for work and my flight leaves in the morning. So I'm not gonna be able to do like a video of the results or how it looks, but my loving wife is gonna send me pictures and I'm gonna edit them into the video, and I'll put those pictures in the video right here so that you can see this grass green up and come to life. And then yeah, that's pretty much it. All right, so as you can see, 105 heat index today. Humidity here in South Mississippi is absolutely horrible. You can sweat like this sitting in the shade just as much as you can out doing physical labor. So excuse the drenched shirt. That's it, man. We have took this grass down, started lowering the height of cut, dethatched, scarified, killed the weeds, treated for fungus, and now we have started pushing growth and lowering the height of cut. Man, if you'll just stick with me, you're gonna see this thing come back and bounce back into something very beautiful. My goal is to show you that you don't have to have $800 fertilizer spreaders and $1,000 driveway edger, and you don't have to spend $105 on a 2-gallon jug of fertilizer. My job is to make it easy for you, dummy proof it, show you that it's not that technical. It's grass, man. It's grass. A lot of exciting videos coming up here in the future, so just stay tuned, and we're going to carry this show all the way through winter too. We're not going to stop this show at the end of summer. We're going back with our trusted perennial ryegrass this winter, and there's so many more exciting videos coming before winter even gets here. So if you don't want any lies and you want to know the truth about yard maintenance and care and turf maintenance, subscribe to the channel, give it a thumbs up, comment down below if you got any questions, and we'll see y'all in the next one.